Language immersion is often sold as the magical method to learn languages in a very short time. In a not-so-flexible way, it requires throwing yourself into a foreign country with little to no knowledge of the language and having you survive in it. It uses both the need to communicate to get something like food and the body's alert state, where you bring yourself to the highest focus point to remember, memorize, and learn new things as fast as possible. In a more flexible way, you don't need to travel, and immersion is often done through the internet. We can say it's a very important part of every class planning, so you're very likely to do it when you take a course. But things get complicated when you grow up and get responsibilities, like tons of schoolwork or even a job. So today I want to teach you some subtle ways to immerse yourself in a language while enjoying the culture it belongs to. At this point, I can say I've tried a lot of resources and techniques to learn languages, and I can tackle new languages with not much issue. But when it comes to Korean, I basically enjoy the content but avoid the learning, and it has affected how I tackle my speaking skills and my progress overall. I currently have a job with enough free time to study, but I lack motivation. So if I don't review and study, I don't have opportunities to use Korean in my everyday life. Because even when making Korean food, I read the instructions in English. I have used books, I have used super specific study plans, I have used songs, I have used apps. I have tried to make Korean friends, I even tried to write a Korean short story once. In the end, it all comes down to me not being comfortable enough to use the language. There are a bunch of techniques to help with immersion when you're not living in a country that speaks your target language, but most of them involve speaking with people, which I have failed to do, and being motivated, which I'm also not into right now. So I came up with some techniques to slowly replace everyday activities and habits, to trick my brain into learning Korean while making it feel like I'm not actually in a study mode, just chilling and enjoying the culture. And this is how to make the perfect cheat immersion plan. We are usually learning a language because we like something from the culture or because it's a requirement of some sort. Despite which situation we're in, we need to find something within the culture that we like. It could be a food, a certain show, a book by a writer from that culture, an actor, etc. Culture is a very ideal aspect to build motivation, because even when all motivation is gone, we still have that attachment to the culture that creates curiosity and inevitably leads to wanting to know more and more. Let's take me as an example. Right now, I enjoy going through music, watching K-dramas, and Stray Kids content. Out of them, only music and Stray Kids content are part of my everyday life. The other is mostly casual. So to evaluate how useful either of them can be, I try to break down how often I consume that content and the situation or ambient in which I consume it. For music, I consume around 2 to 3 hours 5 times a week, but I do it while working, so I'm not able to put my focus into it. That is enough for now. I would say I watch K-dramas 2 to 4 hours once a week, and I usually do it in my free time, so that one could work. And I watch Stray Kids content on TikTok every day, also in my free time, so that one is also a goal. So the way this works is by finding the most effortless changes in your routine that force you to have some interaction with the language. I only have visual content as my current tools, so my best option is to remove subtitles. That forces me to focus on the language that is being spoken, so I can recall the information that I have about it in my brain. It also has the advantage of language immersion, since I can learn both grammar patterns and new vocabulary just by paying attention to the context and trying to infer the meaning. For me, it's also important that I don't make it seem like a tedious task. So to make it easier, I will only be using K-dramas and K-movies that I have already finished, so it doesn't ruin my experience with the new ones. I will also not prohibit myself from using subtitles if I need them. I will just opt to have them off most of the time. Stream platforms have the option to turn them on and off, but there are also tools like Subtitle Hider that can help in situations where it's not easy to turn them off, like maybe a stream party with friends. For TikTok, I just have to ignore the subtitles. There's no other way. I just have to try not to see them and be chill about it. Sometimes videos have big letters on them that are hard to ignore. So it's okay if I end up seeing them or relying on them. I'm just trying to build the habit of not doing it as often. And that's it. That's my super lazy immersion plan. There are other tools that people use to immerse themselves in a language, like putting post-its around the house with the name of the objects in their target language. But the bad side is that your brain gets used to the information that is being displayed, and you don't challenge yourself to use the language in different ways. Enjoying the culture even in times of procrastination, it's always going to help with your learning more than you can imagine. Trying the food, watching their shows, maybe even following a workout routine or a tutorial in your target language. It all can help with rewiring your brain and getting used to this new language identity. Have you tried doing something similar? Let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching. See you next time.